the GHSA Basketball State Finals presented by Breda Pest Management, the official sponsor of high school basketball. As we welcome you back to the Macon Coliseum, it's the 6A Boys Championship game as the number one ranked Alexander Cougars take on the second ranked Lee County Trojans. And good evening. I'm Matt Stewart, joined by former McDonald's All-American and Georgia Bulldogs point guard Sean Golden and Sean Alexander playing in their first ever state championship game. Lee County in their second ever, but their first since winning it all, their one and only back in 1985. And this promises to be a very even matchup.
Well, the key thing we're going to talk about tonight, and both teams have dreamed about this, is the state championship. Think about it. Friday night, you playing for the state championship. So this is one thing that they've talked about from day one, day two, day three, and now we're at the end. So the anticipation is here. The final game is here. Let's sit back and watch a great basketball game this evening.
Let's talk about the Alexander Cougars. They're led by their 6'8 big man, Braden Liu, who is their leading scorer, their leading rebounder, and has 20-plus college basketball offers.
16.7 rebounds, 2 steals a game, a top junior guy that can play inside out, can stretch the floor, region player of the year, and his coaches say he's the hardest worker on the team, and he's going to get better every day he plays the game of basketball.
Lee County led by their point guard, DJ Taylor, who is number one in the entire nation in assists per game.
A playmaker, a floor general, a guy that has eyes in the back of his head. He sees the open player. He makes the dish. Think about it. Number one in the nation in assist. He's going to be spraying the floor, trying to get those easy baskets for his teammates and be a playmaker tonight for a state championship opportunity.
Let's take a look at the starting lineups. They are powered by the Dairy Alliance, global advocates for dairy as an essential ingredient to life. And for the 27-5 Cougars, they'll go Noah Melson, the senior, who is committed to Chattanooga. Milan Kennedy, the senior guard. Jaquan Nelson, who averages right at 14 points per game. Marvin McGee, the senior forward, who coach Jason Slate calls the heart and soul of the team. And then the aforementioned Braden Liu rounding out the starting lineup. And for the Lee County Trojans at 28-3. Christian Brown right at 9 points per game. The aforementioned DJ Taylor. Harrison Skinner, the senior guard. Usmani Croma, the sophomore, who's also one of the top running backs in the state as a 10th grader. And Mark Sade, the senior, lines up there. A young man who just came from Lebanon 3 months ago.
Well, Alexander's ready to win this game. And talking to Coach Slate, he said last season was a teaching moment. Our guys had to go through some adversity. And this year, we had a tough non-region schedule. We had to fight, fight, fight. But he knew his team. He put his team in a position to fight and be consistent and knew what it took to win a championship. They would be here in a position to cut down nets. But Lee County, on the other hand, they want to score in transition. They're going to make it a track meet. So it's almost which one prevails, fast tempo or under control tempo. Let's just sit back and watch it prevail.
So here you go, Alexander, the Region 5, 6A champions. They were 14-1, won their region title, came in as the number one seed. Lee County, the Region 1, 6A champions. They went 9-1 in region play. They also won their region title, beating veterans in the championship game and the number one seed. Lee County, semifinal win over Lanier, 49-48 to get here. Alexander, 56-53 win over Etowah to get here. And we're underway with Lee County in their white uniforms starting on offense. Stolen away by Alexander, then stolen back by Lee County. Inside they go, nearly stepped out of bounds. Strong power move inside for Croma.
You can feel the energy with Lee County. They're right up the street from Macon, so it's a lot of people there to support this team, and they're going to feed off that energy.
Straight away three almost, and the miss by Kennedy. Kennedy gets it back. He's a 33% three-point shooter. Wing three and off the mark by Nelson. Actually, I believe that was Liu who took that first three-pointer for Alexander, or the second one. Harrison Skinner up top. Taylor to the corner, and they throw it away.
Go good ball movement there by Lee County, but just an unforced turnover, and that's exactly what you don't need in trying to win a state championship. Unforced turnovers can actually accumulate and then give you a sense of lack of confidence. So you got to stay positive and true to who you are, but make more solid plays on the offensive end.
So Alexander coach Jason Slade in his 12th season, 225 wins, 104 losses. That's a 3. 0 for 3. Alexander starts behind the arc. Christian Brown, rebound, up, and Sade misses. And out of bounds off the baseline, it'll be Alexander's ball.
Well, I love the energy that both teams are portraying offensively, defensively, just giving it all. Guys, we're going to win the state championship, but in order to do that, we got to leave our energy and our passion on the court. Nothing left behind.
Braden Liu gets it back. Puts it on the floor, spin move, and rolls in. First basket for Alexander in the state championship game.
Well, that was a big time basket by Lou, being able to penetrate to the baseline for the spin. And if he can make plays like that, he's going to have a huge night for Alexander for the Cougars.
Averages 16.1 points, 7.7 rebounds per game. And Sade fumbles the ball out of bounds.
This is a big-time play, big-time player. Big-time players make big-time plays and big-time games.
Melson on the drive. Corner three, McGee did not get the bounce. Saved by Alexander. Wing three. Rebound. Lou going to drive the baseline. Bounce it back into the middle. It's stolen by Lee County. Skinner, long-range three.
He shot that from downtown. That's Skinner for the three. And when you can shoot in transition, especially a three-point shot, now the defense, really, you have the defense on their heels. And that's a confident shot, big confident shot for Lee County, knowing that we can shoot threes, we can drive to the rim, and now it's going to open up the offense for Lee County going forward.
Deep three, there's an assist by Taylor, and a deep three from the wing, Harrison Skinner, who averages 6.5 points per game.
And that's assist number one for Taylor.
5-2 lead for Lee County here. Quick timeout was called by Alexander after that deep three, and the Trojans have a three-point lead. Lee County averaging 59.6 points per game, Alexander 65.2, so don't expect this game to get very high scoring. Probably winner's going to end up in the 50s as you take a look at Kervin Davis in his ninth season as the Trojans head coach. Three, Noah Melson. Alexander off to a slow start right there. They're 0 for 5.
Here's that playmaker coming down the court looking to make plays.
On the floor, in the paint. Rebound pulled down by Lou. Ahead it comes to Nelson. Jaquan Nelson, shot was blocked. And last touched out of bounds by Alexander. So maybe a little bit of nerves, Sean, for Alexander. They're 1-for-8 shooting. They're 0-for-5 on their threes. And they've committed a turnover so far here in the first 3.5 minutes.
Well, that's natural. I mean, it's a championship game. So you're not going to come out of the gates where everything is going to be perfect. It's going to take you probably a good quarter for everything to settle down. But I love the tempo of the game.
Josiah Parker on the dribble. And the pass to the wing gets knocked out of bounds.
And see, in games like this, it's one of those games where you don't want to make mistakes because, you know, if you make that one mistake, it could result in a made basket, a transition basket. But you've got to relax. And in order for them to relax, it's going to take a little bit more time.
Parker on the dribble working against Lou. Step back three. Lou got a piece of it. McGee goes up for the rebound. Foul's going to be called on Lee County. That's going to go against Chroma. Ousmane Chroma called for the foul. We'll step aside. We've got a timeout on the floor. Just over 4 minutes to play in the opening quarter. Trojans out to a three-point lead.
Sweetheart, please don't forget to wear your seatbelt.
I got it, Mom. It's a really nice day, living in the right space. Breathing your face, got me feeling some kind of way.
In the blink of an eye, so many tomorrows can disappear. Buckle up for your future. Every trip, every time. A message from the Governor's Office of Highway Safety.
In lively towns and peaceful rural areas, Georgia's electric membership cooperatives are on a mission to provide a different kind of electricity. Our not-for-profit, member-owned EMCs are focused on making life better for members. At private residences, farms, and thriving businesses, we work for you. Generating safe, reliable, affordable electricity, giving back to local programs, serving our members to make life brighter. Georgia's EMCs, so much more than electricity.
At Regions Bank, we're here to listen to your needs, and we'll customize a plan to help you reach your financial goals. Our service to Georgia goes beyond banking to creating more inclusive prosperity in our communities. From education to financial wellness to economic development, we're working to level the playing field so more people can succeed and our communities can thrive.
Five-two lead Lee County. They're going for their second state championship, their first and only since 1985. So you wonder what was going on in 1985. Well, Ronald Reagan had begun his second term as president. Amadeus, best picture at the Academy Awards. The Chicago Bears, Mike Ditka, won the Super Bowl. The Live Aid concert in London and Philadelphia. And Lee County won their one and only state championship, something they'll try to change here tonight and make it their second state championship. None of these players and some of the coaches were not even born in 1985.
Yeah, 1985 was an interesting year, but in looking at this game, you got two equally matched teams, Matt. You got two teams. No one overpowers the other. The winning formula is going to be this: execution, made shots, and whoever has the least turnovers.
Corner three, Lou. Battle for the rebound. One by Alexander in the paint, up and in. Nice move by Nelson.
Well, second chance shots always go to the offensive team. You've got to box out if you're Lee County. Keep Alexander off the offensive glass.
That snapped a streak of five consecutive missed shots. They're now 2 of 10 from the floor. They've cut the lead to one. Parker missed up close, got his own miss and put it in.
That's a big time play. We talked about it. Second chance points always goes to the offense because the offense can go real back up quicker and get that easy too.
Josiah Parker, a good looking 6'6 sophomore, got a lot of length. McGee off the iron. Rebound controlled by Lee County. In transition, one and done. Here comes Alexander. Alexander lit on the basket. They are just having a devil of a time shooting the ball right now. They're under 20%.
Well, everything's become a three-point shot for Alexander, so they've got to slow down in half court, get some cuts to the basket, get the ball moving left side, right side, get more action offensively, and then you get a high percent shot.
Dribble drive action up and in. Christian Brown with the basket.
The glue guy. The guy that keeps this Lee County team together, making shots defensively, defending the best ball handler on the opposing team.
Drive action, trying to reverse layup. Parker clears the rebound for Lee County. They're running again, and they get out of control. Break opportunity for Alexander. Back to Lou, up and in. And a foul, and one for Braden Lou. Thank you.
Nice turnover. But I like the fact that he advanced the ball up the court to his teammate and then received it back for the three-point play opportunity.
Parker was called for the foul. He now has two. That's the two team fouls for Lee County in this game. See Alexander 3 of 6 on their twos, but 0 for 8 on their threes. And Braden Liu at the line to try and complete the three-point play, which he does. Liu has 5 of their 7. It rolls and goes in.
And Alexander scoring off of their defense. Defense points. Their offense becomes their defense. And when you can do that, when you're an offensive team that's struggling from the three-point line, layups in transition gives your offense a little bit more confidence and shots to start going in.
An official's timeout here as they get the clock straight. You see Jason Slate, his 12th season at Alexander, with 225 victories for the Cougars. Driving the baseline, up and in. Strong move by Chroma.
Chroma attacking on the baseline. That was really good offense for him and great body control while he finishes at the basket.
Now you can tell he's a great running back. Look at his thick legs. He's just got so much athleticism. Back the other way, Alexander scores very quickly. We're tied again at 11.
And I like what Alexander's doing. They realize they're not scoring well in the half court, so now they're trying to make it a defensive game by enforcing the full court press.
Gonna have a foul called on Alexander. You could see the reaction of Coach Slade. He wasn't happy about it. Foul goes against Gravett. That's Christian Gravett. His brother Hassani starred in this program. Played at South Carolina, now playing in the NBA G League. Bounce pass into the post and Chroma missed close. And tied up by Caden King. That's going to be a foul on him.
Good defense down low. Verticality contest. Rebounded with two hands. And that is textbook basketball. Eliminate the second chance scoring opportunity. Secure the rebound. And now get an offensive possession.
Alexander's hit their last three shots and starting two for 13, but they just turned it over right there. That's their second turnover. Ball pinballs around. Who wants it? Kick ball. It's going to be Alexander's ball with 36 and a half seconds to play in the quarter.
But Alexander got back into this game because of their defense. Defense and hustle plays. Plays that you do not see in the stat book, but you feel them in the victory or defeat. Hustle plays.
Kirvin Davis, first four seasons, losing seasons at Lee County since starting the turnaround in this program. This has been their best year at 28-3. It's a difference of just a few tenths of seconds on the game clock and the shot clock here. And Liu dribbles the ball out of bounds. And Lee County is going to get the final possession in this quarter, Sean, to try and take the lead at the end of the first quarter.
Well, Matt, watching the game and the last two possessions that Liu Braden received, every time he receives the ball, he's getting double-teamed. If you're watching, he's getting double-teamed. So he's got to learn how to move without the ball, pass it and cut, and then create a mismatch opportunity, maybe go down low sometimes, use his height and length to post up.
Lee has hit three of their last five shots. We're down to 10 seconds to play in the quarter. They run a trap at him. Caden Lee is left open to the wing and a three, and nailed it! Big-time shot for Lee County in the final seconds of the first quarter. And the Trojans take a 14-11 lead to the bench. Braylon Chaney knocks down a three from the wing. Lee County, 14-11 lead after 8 minutes of play.
Hey guys, it's time to reveal what I'm doing after graduation. We got my cupcakes and we got my schools. Let's just do it. Cupcakes aren't really my thing, and neither is going to a four-year college. Instead, I'm getting paid $18 an hour to train as a commercial plumber. There's a ton of other trades, like electrical and carpentry, where you can make great money, live a great lifestyle with little to no debt, and even be your own boss.
Let me know if I can help you with anything.
Just looking. I only buy local and sustainable, so.
Oh, well, that shirt's not local. You should be wearing cotton. Georgia's a major supplier of cotton worldwide, so if you'd like to buy local to support Georgia, buying cotton's a great place to start. It's renewable and sustainable, naturally.
Thanks.
Now that's a polyester fiber made of oil, by the way.
Where's your dressing room?
DBHDD and the Governor's Red Ribbon Campaign is about all Georgians standing together for substance abuse prevention. Celebrate life. Live drug-free. Learn more about healthy alternatives and living a drug-free lifestyle at garedribbon.org.
Start of the second quarter, Lee County leading Alexander 14-11 in the 6A state championship game. Matt Stewart along with Sean Golden, DJ Taylor, top assist man in the entire country, just one assist in that first quarter. Dribble drive all the way to the basket and one, Gregory Dunson.
And Matt, as I think about that first quarter, one of the things I was going to say, if you're Alexander, stop being a jump shot team. This is not the game for you to shoot jump shots. Your thought process needs to be cuts to the basket, dives to the baskets, and drives to the baskets. Get to the free throw line.
Cheney was called for the foul. And Gregory Dunson, a 71% free throw shooter on the season, fails to convert on the three-point play. King the rebound. DJ Taylor gonna step back and set up the offense. Three from the wing. Cheney hit one at the end of the first quarter, all the way through. Dunson misses. King gets another board. And last touched by Lee County. Alexander's ball in the corner.
But again, you see Alexander in transition, getting to the rim, getting high efficient shots. That's how they're going to win the game. When they start playing on the perimeter, talking about Alexander, it takes them away from their strength. They're bigger, they're stronger than Lee County. Use what you have to your advantage.
Braden Liu just checked back into the game. He has five of their first 13 points. Errant pass sails out of bounds.
Good thought process, great action. A little too quick, but I love the action. If Alexander goes back to that action, then you have Lou down at the bottom with a mismatch and the opportunity to use his size and strength to get some easy points.
That's the fourth turnover for Alexander. Lee County scored six off of that. Make it eight as Caden Lee sticks it in.
And see, Lee County's a scrappy team. Scrappy teams are hard to play against because they make you uncomfortable. That's the game plan for Lee County. Play scrappy from the start to the finish.
And we have a whistle. Foul's gonna go against Chroma. It's gonna be number two on him.
See, the thing about playing against a team that's scrappy, Matt, it kind of takes you out of your comfort zone. So you have to play with a little bit more tenacity so that you can get those easy baskets, those loose balls, deflections, things that actually work with you and work to your advantage offensively and defensively.
Jaquan Nelson inside the arc. Caden King snags another board. He's got five of those already. Out of control, Lee County. Get bailed out. A foul is going to be called on Alexander.
But that's the speed of the game that Lee County understands. One speed, either it's a 9 or a 10. There's going to be a moment they have to actually pull it back, But right now, they're playing their game up by three here in the second quarter.
Foul number one on McGee. Balanced attack for Lee County here in the first 10 minutes of the game. And a 16-13 lead for the Trojans. Christian Brown picked up his dribble, got to get rid of it. To Skinner, takes a bomb three off the back iron. Might be a little bit out of his range right there. And a foul called on Lee County. That's going to be the third team foul. Christian Brown picks up the foul, number one on him.
And see, that's Braden with the rebound. That's where he's effective defensively. Be a presence in the paint, but rebound the basketball and then attack down low when you get on offense.
They dump it into Lou. He beat the defense. Missed up close. Got his own miss. Missed again. Keeps it alive on the glass, and a foul is going to be called.
And that's what I talked about a few minutes ago. That's how Alexander wins the game, taking advantage of your height, your strength, and your length. High-low action, good basketball, but Braden's got to come up and get that three-point play.
So Lou being very active on the glass. 6'8", 220-pound junior forward who has approximately 20 D1 offers. For you, at the end of your junior year, going into the senior year, what point did you commit?
I didn't commit until my last visit to the University of Georgia. I initially committed to Syracuse.
Right.
And
was that senior year?
That was my senior year.
Senior
year.
So you waited.
I waited. That was the name of the game. But now, with social media, your interest level with the school you want to go to, a lot of kids commit early.
Yeah, I would think this summer is going to be really big for him from a recruiting standpoint. DJ Taylor. Inside he goes to King. Nicely done. There's a second assist for DJ Taylor.
And that was a beautiful pass. Nice bounce pass there for the finish down low for King. So when you see your point guard dishing and making plays, that's a good sign for Lee County.
Right through the defense, Jaquan Nelson.
But look at how they're scoring. If there's a shot chart right now with Alexander, all made baskets are within the paint.
Pull up, Parker, hard off the glass and rim. They get it back. Skinner takes a three. And last touch by Alexander, Lee County's ball. We will step aside, timeout on the floor. Lee County leading Alexander by two, under five to play in the half.
Sweetheart, please don't forget to wear your seatbelt.
I got it, Mom. It's a really nice day, living in the right space. Breathing your face, got me feeling some kind of way.
Of an eye, so many tomorrows can disappear. Buckle up for your future. Every trip, every time. A message from the Governor's Office of Highway Safety.
Today's conservation-minded consumer cares about where their energy comes from. Your local EMC cares too. Georgia's electric membership cooperatives offer renewable options for our members. In fact, our solar portfolio will produce enough clean energy to power more than 180,000 households. Striving to move the needle toward progress and position communities for the future. Georgia's EMCs, so much more than electricity.
At Regions Bank, we're here to listen to your needs and we'll customize a plan to help you reach your financial goals. Our service to Georgia goes beyond banking to creating more inclusive prosperity in our communities. From education to financial wellness to economic development, we're working to level the playing field so more people can succeed and our communities can thrive.
Alexander down two to Lee County here midway through the second quarter, road to the finals for the Cougars. And you will see that every one of their victories on the road to the state championship, single-digit wins over Rome in the first round, Shiloh in the Sweet 16, at Jonesboro in the Elite Eight, and then Etowah in the Final Four semifinals. And last year they lost to Grovetown in the playoffs, Sean, and Coach Slate felt like they kind of got beat up in the game. They wanted to get tougher, scheduled more aggressively this year, played Sagemont, state champion out of Florida, Hoover, state champion out of Alabama, even played Grayson from 7A. They felt like they accomplished the mission this year with the regular season.
Well, that's what it's about. How do you get better? That's what teams and coaches got to understand. We don't start better. We get better throughout the season, but it starts with a tough schedule and a commitment to succeed by the entire team and the entire program.
Yeah, they played 12 neutral site games. They were 9-3 on a neutral floor this year. Went 9-1 at home. Wing three, knocked it down. Noah Melson, first basket for him.
And that's a kid that's averaging close to 10 points a game, and his strength is shooting threes. So great action, good curl cut. He teed it up, and now that action could really open up more drives and cuts to the basket for Alexander.
Caden Lee, shot blocked from behind by McGee. Run out opportunity. Here's Nelson on the break. Euro step, flips it up over his shoulder, and it ended up being a poor shot. A little too hard on the glass. Taylor, coast to coast, lays it in with the left hand.
That was a big time shot by DJ Taylor, crossing the court, finishing with his left hand. A guy that does it all. Now he's having to score a little bit to help alleviate the pressure for his teammates.
He averages a double-double, but I got to be honest, Sean, I've never seen a double-double where the back end of that double-double was assist.
Yeah, when you're a pure point guard like this, you got to have your eyes up, always looking to attack under control. He didn't go too fast. He didn't go too slow. He attacked it at the right time, and now he's got a chance to get a little rest and get ready to come back here in a few minutes.
So Taylor goes to the bench. Hardwood was called for the foul. Alexander inbounds on the baseline, right to Lou, and another foul called on Lee County. And they are now over the limit, and that will put Alexander in the bonus for the final 3:24 of this half.
And see, Lou Brayton, this is something that, from a coach's point of view, you're going to talk to him in here in halftime. You've had four or five opportunities to secure a three-point play. You've got to be more focused in the paint, and you got to finish stronger, because that's probably 8 points that he should have, and Alexander should be probably up by four or five here in the second quarter.
Game tied at 20. Foul was called on Christian Brown, by the way. That's two on him. They've got three players already with two fouls. That could be an issue late in this game. Nearly stolen away in the open court by McGee, who nearly jumped the route, as they like to say in football.
With the size and length of Alexander, they can play a little bit more in space and get those steals in transition and get those deflections.
Yeah, they've got some great length. Lou 6'8", McGee 6'7", Melson 6'6". And then they can bring some more length in off the bench.
I say, I like this switch. Good switch basketball goes a long way, especially when you got a penetrator like CJ, like DJ.
Taylor right in there amongst the trees.
He's not afraid. He's going to attack the paint and throw it up high for the teardrop. Great finish by the young fella.
Yeah, fearless 5'11 guard. Offensive foul on Marvin McGee.
And see, McGee's got to see when the double team is coming. And he was trying to create the dribble drop step. But when you see the double team coming, kick it out. Kick it out just a little quicker, and his teammate is wide open. That was a great charge, though. Give credit to the defense. When you can absorb that type of contact, and then, you know, that's sacrificing yourself in a championship game.
See who it was? It was DJ Taylor again.
Well, you know, you lead by example, not just offensively, but defensively.
Now Cheney will bring it up. They'll play Taylor off the ball. Now they get it to him. Taylor breaking it down, pulls up for the mid-range. Ball kept alive. Lou ends up with it. He's going to bring it across and go all the way. There's contact, whistle, foul against Lee County.
And he's going to live at the free throw line tonight if he keeps attacking under control. He's got good body control. He's got good handles, maybe a little tighter. But his ability to be crafty and get to the rim, that's impressive.
Well, he's going to have to make his free throws, as you already pointed out here. He's a 71% free throw shooter on the team, and coming into the game, he had been to the line a team leading 146 times with a team leading 103 makes.
Well, with his size and strength and his quickness, he has to attack the rim. And you got to take advantage of what the opportunity presents. When it presents little for big, go to the rim. If you got a big, use your quickness to get past him or hit the outside shot.
You see Sadek has come back into the game for Lee County. Alexander up a point. 2 minutes to play here, first half. Skinner bounces into Taylor on the block. And a foul called against Alexander.
How about that? The smallest guy on the court.
Posting up.
Posting up with a sense of toughness and physicality. Give me the ball down low. I'm going to post up like Akeem Olajuwon at 5'11".
And Gravett took a head butt right to the face. Foul was on the floor, not on the shot. So that's three team fouls on Alexander. Comes in to Braylon Chaney. And Chaney lost the dribble.
See, get the ball, get the ball. What are you waiting for?
Step back three, Melson in and out. They missed an opportunity for a nail layup there. Got to hustle for it. Lou, baseline jumper. Alexander shooting less than 32% here in the first half.
And see, that was a missed opportunity by Alexander in transition. You go aggressive off the loose ball, and you'll go to the rim as tough and as hard as you can.
And Lou goes up for the dunk and can't connect. That was Melson, not Lou. And he got fouled on the play by King. But King, no dunks allowed. You're not going to let him dunk.
Well, that's one thing to go for the dunk. But if you go with a sense of focus and determination, that's probably a three-point play. Attack the rim. You don't try to make it a pretty play. You attack the rim. Just little mustard right there. He tried to put a little mustard on the play, but make the two free throws. Get up by three with a minute and change going into halftime.
So Melson hit the first free throw to give Alexander a two-point lead. And the Cougars are 8 of 10 shooting free throws in this game. Foul on the floor. This is going against Alexander. That's going to be number 4 on them.
This is a quote by Dean Smith. He said, good players make easy plays hard. Great players make hard plays easy. Does that make sense?
Yes. Final minute of the first half and a two-point lead stolen away.
Attack the rim.
Dunson gives it inside to Hutchinson. He missed it, but Melson trailing on the play.
And see, that happened because they went straight to the rim, Alexander did. There wasn't any showboating. It was attack mode and the great follow-up by Melson in transition.
This 4-point lead for Alexander is their biggest of the game.
But we go back to the shot chart. It's not about the perimeter play of Alexander. It's their ability to score within the paint. Get to the rim and drive. Get to the rim in post-ups. Get to the rims in transition. And get to the free throw line.
You saw Gravett go to the bench. He's got 3 personal fouls. Full court pressure here by Alexander. Final 30 seconds. Shot clock is off. 10-8 advantage. Alexander points off turnovers. Sadeh looking into the low block. Now goes to Skinner. To King. 16 seconds. King picked up his dribble. Now tries to take the shot. Got blocked. Got fouled. Hutchinson had a chance for a clean block, but ended up fouling him instead.
But defensively, the number one rule is to stay in between the man and the basket. It's one thing to be aggressive, but it's one thing to be simple with your basketball play. Stay between the man and the basket. Now you put Lee County here at the free throw line to possibly cut it down to two.
Caden King gets the bounce. Five points for King so far today and six rebounds. He's had a solid first half and 12 minutes of work.
Well, he's playing hard. I like that. He's playing hard and he's competing. And once you can do that and hit shots, you're an effective player on the team.
Averages 5.7 rebounds per game. He's got 6 and 6 here in the first half.
Get the ball to the high post.
Dunson. Passes out, wing three, 2 seconds on the clock, long three at the horn. That is the end of the first half. And we told you it was going to be a tight, competitive game between two evenly matched teams. And, Sean, that's what we got after 16 minutes.
26-24, Alexander up by two. From a coach's point of view, guys, let's focus on our strength. We're playing to our weaknesses, and we got to get back to our basics.
Two-point lead for the Cougars. Let's send it to Hannah Gooden.
Thank you, Matt. Thank you, Sean. Coming up on the Halftime Show, we'll break down what's happened and what's to come on our GHSA Championship coverage. Check in with John at Macon Coliseum and hear from some special guests. It's all next right here on GBB Sport.
The best defense to stopping bugs and critters? That would be Breda Pest Management, protecting homes all over Georgia for nearly 50 years. See why so many homes are protected by Breda Pest Management at BREDAPest.com.
We continue our coverage of National Signing Day. We go now to Atlanta, Georgia for Kevin Connor's official declaration.
After giving it much thought, I've decided that next year I'll be going pro and building my skills as a Georgia plumber!
What impacted your decision?
It was an opportunity to earn money and learn on the job. I really love working with my hands, building things, and being part of a team.
Another highly touted prospect enters the trades.
Go Plumbers!
All right, what do you think, Jasper?
Honestly, I think that polyester shirt's affecting your game.
What?
I think cotton would have been a better choice.
Cotton?
Yeah, it's come a long way, you know. Nowadays, cotton breathes and looks moisture great. Plus, buying cotton means supporting Georgia farmers. I think that's wonderful.
Okay, sure, but what do you think about the putt?
Oh, guess really hadn't thought about it.
Welcome to the Halftime Show. I'm Hannah Gooden. We're live from the GBB Sports Studios in Atlanta. It's halftime of the GHSA 6A boys title game between Alexander and Lee County. Let's get you caught up on what's happened and what's to come on our GBB Championship scoreboard. So here's the game we're in right now. This has been a close one all game. Alexander leads 26-24 at the half. John and I will talk more about that first half later in the show. This is day 3 of 4 of our live coverage. Earlier today at 1 o'clock, Heber and Christian won it second state 3A girls title in 3 years with a 68-36 win over the defending champs, Lumpkin County. At 3 o'clock, Sandy Creek went 4-0 against Cedar Grove to earn its first ever state title. Final score, 66-37. At 5 o'clock, we had our girls' three-point shootout. Raven County's Ellie Southards won it. At 5:30, River Ridge took down the defending champs, Lovejoy, for the night's very first 6A girls title. Final score, 68-50. We've got one more day tomorrow, so more basketball action to come and more from the Halftime Show. We'll be right back with some special guests.
Sweetheart, please don't forget to wear your seatbelt.
I got it, Mom. It's a really nice day, living in the right space. Breathing your face, got me feeling some kind of way.
In the blink. blink of an eye, so many tomorrows can disappear. Buckle up for your future. Every trip, every time. A message from the Governor's Office of Highway Safety.
As morning light signals the start of business, Georgia's Electric Membership Cooperatives are right there with you. Georgia's EMCs are a partner in economic development, serving commercial accounts big and small that drive Georgia's economy. From leading industries we rely on to local shops we treasure, we support operations on the ground, care around the clock, and growth through the seasons, lighting up good business so business is good. Georgia's EMCs, so much more than electricity.
At Regions Bank, we're here to listen to your needs, and we'll customize a plan to help you reach your financial goals. Our service to Georgia goes beyond banking to creating more inclusive prosperity in our communities. From education to financial wellness to economic development, we're working to level the playing field so more people can succeed and our communities can thrive.
Welcome back. It's halftime of the GHSA 6A Boys Championship game between Alexander and Lee County. Let's check in with John Nelson, who's standing by with the principals for the Cougars and the Trojans. And John, I hear you're not only in the principal's office, but also the doctor's office as well.
Absolutely correct. And since I'm a lefty and we're going to my left and I'm very chivalrous, we're going to start with Dr. Karen Hancock, the principal at Lee County. You're here in full force, and it's a four-day weekend?
Four-day weekend, yes. We're off Friday through Monday, yes.
You've got the holiday here. What's it like to see the support coming here from Leesburg?
Oh, it's just amazing. You know, we travel well. Our student section is wide open. We took four buses, brought a band, cheerleaders, basketball, community, parents. We're all here and in attendance.
Great to see you. As you're chasing after a title, first time, long time. All right, let's go to the flip side. Catch up with Dr. Christopher Small, the principal at Alexander. Same thing for you for Douglas County. Douglas County coming down here to making your supports off the rails.
Yeah, it's just exciting. That's the strength of our program, our school, our community is the support that we have in our student section. And, you know, we start the season with excitement and we just keep rolling through and the momentum has continued. And we're just so excited for Coach Slate and the staff and the players. It's just an amazing experience.
Fantastic. Great to catch up with Dr. Christopher Small, the principal at Alexander, Dr. Karen Hancock, the principal at Lee County. It is Alexander and Douglas County. It is Lee County and Leesburg representing. That's what's going on right here. Tight game, and they can't wait to go and watch the second half. Hannah, let's send it back to you in Atlanta.
John, we have to take one more quick break, but stick around for a breakdown of the first half next.
Hey guys, it's time to reveal what I'm doing after graduation. We got my cupcakes and we got my schools. Let's just do it. Cupcakes aren't really my thing, and neither is going to a four-year college. Instead, I'm getting paid $18 an hour to train as a commercial plumber. There's a ton of other trades, like electrical and carpentry, where you can make great money, live a great lifestyle with little to no debt, and even be your own boss.
I've been checking food labels for years. I like to buy local, and I like to buy healthy for my family. So I started checking the labels on our clothes, too. Did you know synthetic fibers like polyester are pretty much made of oil? No thanks. I look for cotton now, which grows right here in Georgia, a major source of the world's cotton. Cotton is natural, renewable, sustainable, and buying cotton supports Georgia farmers. Good enough for me and my family.
Sweetheart, please don't forget to wear your seatbelt.
I got it, Mom. It's a really nice day, living in the right space. Breathing your face, got me feeling some kind of way.
Blink of an eye, so many tomorrows can disappear. Buckle up for your future. Every trip, every time. A message from the Governor's Office of Highway Safety.
Welcome back. It's time to break down the first half with John Nelson, who's been right in the middle of all the action. And John, it seemed that Alexander couldn't make some big shots fall there in the second quarter, although they do lead by 2 points against Lee County. What were your observations?
1 of 11 from 3-point for Alexander. And once again, I'm going to do my Sean Golden impression as to what to look out for in the second half. Get into attack mode. Attack mode for Alexander. So we'll see if that happens. Continuing to work the paint as Sean and Matt got to see in the first half. Also on the flip side for Lee County, foul trouble. five different players have two fouls for Lee County, so we'll keep an eye on that coming into the second half as well, because if you get into attack mode, getting into the paint, possibly drawing a lot of these Lee County players into foul trouble, it could be trouble for them late third, early fourth, down the stretch. So a couple of things there. Alexander, not doing well from the arc, doing well in the paint. Foul trouble for Lee County, Hannah. That's what I'm staring at.
Thank you, John. So the second half is to come. Follow us on social media at GBB Sports for constant updates throughout the week. We're also streaming each game live on the GBB Knowledge channel, Facebook, Twitter, Twitch, YouTube, the GBB Sports website, and the GBB Sports app. So that's it for the halftime show. Thanks for watching. It's time to see what Matt and Sean thought about the first half. It's the Cougars and the Trojans. More next. Hey, guys.
Hey, Hannah, thank you very much. You know, two-point lead for Alexander here at the break. You got to feel, though, if Alexander had shot the ball much better and more like they're capable of, could have had a little bit of a different game right here, because only shooting 31% in the first half.
Yeah, 1-for-11 from the three-point line is unheard of when you're trying to win a championship. Use your height and use your side. Attack mode. Attack mode. Get the ball inside. When you're a coach, you say play inside out. No, inside, inside, inside. And then the farthest part you need to go is shooting free throws. Lee County, play scrappy ball. Continue to keep playing scrappy ball. Get on the floor for loose balls. Attack when opportunity presents itself. And we're going to have a good game here in the second half, I feel, Matt.
What he said. Let's take a look at the highlights. Braden Liu, leading scorer for Alexander, had 10 in the first half.
Attack mode, attack mode, attack mode. When Luke gets to the basket, he's effective getting to the rim. And his DJ doing what he does best, attacking the rim. There's his teammate being able to follow up, talking about King. So both teams want to play in transition. And Matt, the thing that stands out to me is points in the paint. That means both teams are actually trying to attack, get to the rim. Three-point shooting, not the strength of both. Alexander 1-for-11, Lee County 2-for-8.
26-24, Alexander on top of Lee County here. As we get ready for the start of the third quarter, we are 16 minutes away on the game clock from crowning a state champion. Lee County trying to win their first since 1985 and just their second in school history. Meantime, Alexander in the big title game for the first time in program history. And Jason Slate, who's been there for over a decade now, and been building this program after jumping ship from county rival Lithia Springs to come to Alexander, has his guys poised to win a state title, but it's going to be tight down the stretch. Here's a look to Lee County road to the finals, opened with a 12-point win over Evans, 7-point win over Riverwood in the Sweet 16, had to come to Atlanta and win in the Elite Eight quarterfinals, a 4-point victory at Blessed Trinity, and then knocked off another very good team, the Lanier Longhorns, in the Final Four semifinals, beat them by just 1 point.
Well, when you think about this game and then watching all the halftime interviews with Nelly there, you'll see the administration from Lee County and the shirts, they all say, make them believe. We've got one more game, which is tonight's game. Lee County come out with scrap ball, and the way that you play effectively, efficiently, being tough and being rugged, you will cut down nets.
DJ Taylor, only two assists so far here in the ball game. He averages 12 and a half per game, which is number one in the nation. So Lee County starting on offense. They spread the floor and ISO DJ Taylor here. He's going to give it up to Christian Brown. And the rebound by Liu. Fires ahead to McGee, who went and missed the slam badly. Mid-range jumper. Ball is in the hands of Lee County. On the break, Josiah Parker.
And think about what I said about what Coach Dean Smith said. Good players make easy plays look hard. Great players make hard plays look easy. If you're McGee, simplify the play. Don't make the home run. Get the 2 points, and now you put your team up by six.
Lob inside. It is denied by Croma. Good defense from Lee County. They can take the lead on this possession, but Taylor loses it out of bounds after a good job by Jaquan Nelson to stick his hand in there and disrupt the play.
And that's one thing, I go back to that McGee play. It's one game, it's one thing to actually attack the rim, being efficient, getting a nice dunk, but to tomahawk it, to try to make it look good, it shows that you're focused on yourself versus the team. And that's one thing Coach Durham always talked about. Who's first, you or the team?
Blue in the paint with the right-handed layup
and
move.
And that's great move from him. Great action, made movement inside by Lou. He went to his strength, made a nice curl, got to the rim for the finish.
12.7 rebounds for Braden Lou. Ball goes to Parker. Cross court, Skinner. Rebound, Alexander. McGee back inside. Missed up close, Nelson. Tied up, jump ball, possession arrow, pointing in favor of Alexander.
And see, with Lou being able to be crafty in the paint, got to his right hand, which is his dominant hand, was able to kiss it off the glass for the easy 2 points.
Inside, Lou with the finish.
And see, that's what we're talking about. Play to your strength. Great underneath, out of bounds play with the inside screen for the lob, the dunk, and the possible for and one.
Off the inbounds, threw it down.
Now that's how he plays. It's not about his outside game, it's more about his athletic ability. Not to say that he can't improve his outside shot, but when you win it, going for a championship, you have to play to the things that make you better, and that's your athletic ability, your height, and your strength.
Cougars with a 4-point lead. Taylor, bounce pass to King, too far out in front.
And see, that's Taylor being a pass-first point guard, and sometimes you have to be a shooting point guard when you get to the depth, to the deepness there of the paint.
Bullet pass to the corner. Nelson gets it back, slashing to the basket, left it short, stays with it. Volleyball tips up there, and the foul's gonna be on Alexander.
Well,
or is it going to be? Oh, it's going to be on Lee County. Pardon me.
Well, the first 3 minutes here of the second half with Alexander, all of their shots have been with inside the paint, whether it's a make or a miss, getting to the rim, and that's McGee. Once McGee gets a chance to finish, that would be a beautiful play. But the good thing is he did get to the paint.
Chroma was called for the foul. That's three on him. One more free throw attempt for Marvin McGee. Averages 11 points, 7 rebounds per game. 71% free throw shooter, and it looks like Caden Lee got busted in the nose, so he's bleeding. They got to take care of that. So they'll tend to him at the end of the bench, and they sub in for him. Sadat comes in. And one more free throw for Marvin McGee. In and out. Chroma gets the rebound. Lee County wants to push. They got some numbers right now. 5-on-4. Taylor tries to go right on through and drew the foul.
And that's the quickness of Taylor just getting into the heart of the defense and transition. Alexander, they have to do a better job of building a wall. You got the height and the length to defend in transition, but communication amongst the teammates will help defend the paint, and there was just bad communication there from underneath out of bounds.
Chroma on the inbounds. Lead back down to 3. Nelson didn't get the bounce. Chroma snags another board.
And see, one pass, one shot is not effective for Alexander because you don't have guys in a position to rebound. Let the ball move side, top side. Get movement, get action in your offense, and you'll get a better shot.
Chroma, spin move, put it in. Strong move by Usmani Chroma.
Big time basket by Chroma. Got the defense on his side, on his hips. Was able to get an easy basket in the paint.
And Lou gets fouled. He's going to go to the line again. He's already been to the line 8 times in this game and 6 for 8 at the stripe.
But what it shows is what Coach Slate, I'm sure he said this at halftime. Guys, look at our 3-point shots. We're not making them. We're 1 for 11. We are effective inside the paint. Attack the rim.
Lead back to 2 with that free throw make right now. This game has been played in a 5-point window. Alexander's led by as much as 5. Lee County's led by as much as 5. So a 10-point space. It's been a tight game.
Well, the thing that actually keeps it tight is the lack of 3-point shooting, because a lack of 3-point shooting actually allows the defenses to be a little bit more tight in the paint, and the shots just aren't as easy to come by.
Lou has scored 10 of Alexander's last 14 points. Here's a break opportunity, and Taylor missed the follow, and 1. Chroma playing aggressively. He's been strong here in the third quarter. Has a chance to tie the game.
And Matt, when you play scrappy ball, you don't give up on the play. Lee County in transition didn't give up on the action. Make shot, miss shot, you have to have someone there to follow up, and that's exactly what Chroma has done on several plays in tonight's game.
Usmani Chroma steps up to the line. He's got 10 points and 6 rebounds. Been very active here in this third quarter. Tie game. 7 of his 11 points have come in this period.
And you talk about Chroma, a guy that's defensive player of the year in basketball and offensive player of the year in football. This kid right here is strong. He has a presence on the floor, and he has a will to win.
Man up, 33-33, just over 4 to play in the third.
Every game day celebration, every championship title begins here with hours of unseen work. As part of our commitment to education, Georgia's EMCs support the young athletes who play high school sports in the communities we serve. Empowering talent with scholarships, honoring sportsmanship, saluting the game changers. When we champion the energy behind the scenes, they can step into their future and shine. Georgia's EMCs, official energy provider of the GHSA.
At Regions Bank, we're here to listen to your needs, and we'll customize a plan to help you reach your financial goals. Our service to Georgia goes beyond banking to creating more inclusive prosperity in our communities. From education to financial wellness to economic development, we're working to level the playing field so more people can succeed and our communities can thrive.
We continue our coverage of National Signing Day. We go now to Atlanta, Georgia for Kevin Connor's official declaration.
After giving it much thought, I've decided that next year I'll be going pro and building my skills as a Georgia plumber!
What impacted your decision?
It was an opportunity to earn money and learn on the job. I really love working with my hands, building things, and being part of a team.
Another highly touted prospect enters the trades.
Go Plumbers!
Woo! 33-33, Alexander, Lee County tied here. And Usmani Chroma, a 7-2 run. He has scored all 7 points as Lee County has pulled even. He is one of the top running backs in the state. Just a sophomore, already has 10 offers, including Georgia and Alabama.
Well, he's one of the top running backs in the country when you talk about those two teams. But his physicality on the court that he brings from football, think about what we said earlier. Defensively, because he's a physical presence. He's a defensive player of the year in the region. Offensively, because of his presence and his size on the football field as a sophomore, he's an offensive player of the year in this region. So here's a kid that has a bright future on the football field, but tonight he's trying to win the state championship on the hardwood.
His recruiting profile says he's 5'11", 180. Well, then I'm 7 foot and 280. Now, he's much bigger than that, isn't he?
He's a beast of a man at a young age.
Skip pass. Dunson misses the 3, tries to save it, and does. Great hustle.
And see, I like the 2-3 zone by Lee County. Let's force the outside play by Alexander, give them the perimeter shots because they're not effective from the field. But when you got a guy like Nelson can hit that mid-range shot, it kind of flattens the defense from Lee County's 2-3 zone.
With that shot, Alexander climbs up to 32% shooting in this game. Lee County is right at 44%, and they're 4-for-7 here in the third quarter, 57%. And timeout call by Kervin Davis as they got kind of stuck over there on the far side of the court from the coach.
And I like that defensive possession there by Alexander, the Cougars, because they decided to man up. They denied reversal passes. In the post, you had Lou just defending Cremona, eliminating that entry pass. That was a great defensive possession there by Alexander, by the Cougars.
Alexander with 6 assists on their 12 field goals made. Lee County has 6 on their 14. And this has just been a fun game. Two teams just going at it as hard as they can, scrapping and battling. It's going to go right down to the wire.
Yeah, this is kind of this is one of those games where it's gutsy. And I just like that both teams are playing with passion. You know, everyone's leaving it on the floor because everyone wants that championship, Matt. They all want to cut down the nets and host up the championship trophy.
Cromer driving along the baseline, lost the dribble, run out opportunity. And the layup by Nelson. And Alexander has reopened a 4-point lead.
Transition basketball, box board run. There's a steal by Alexander on the turnover by Lee County, getting easy 2 points in transition.
DJ Taylor attacking, got his man in the air, teardrop, misses. King, the rebound, got fouled on the floor.
And see, here's the one thing I don't like about that possession, and I'm talking about Alexander. Your best player rebounded on the court was Lou, was at half court looking for the dunk opportunity. You have to rebound, son. You're the tallest player on the court. You got to get in there. You've got to rebound because the smallest player on the opposing team should not be getting that offensive rebound.
Dunson was called for the foul. There's another one on Alexander right there. That's going to be their 4th team foul. Or did they? Looks like they're going to call a travel.
But you got to secure the rebound if you're Alexander. When you're trying to win a game, it's the little things that make a big difference. Rebounds, loose balls. Not steals, loose balls and rebounds win championships.
Lee County winning the rebounding battle right now, 25-22. Nelson, turnaround, strokes it.
Big time shot by Nelson. Mid post up move, but he has a scorer's mindset. He already made his mind up what to do, get the defense off balance for the mid-range jump shot.
Nelson with 8-4, 6-point lead for Alexander. This is their largest lead of the game. You see, we've had 7 ties, 5 lead changes, run out opportunity for the Cougars. Nelson in the open court, gonna take it all the way and lay it in.
Now see, that's how you finish if you're Nelson. You don't wanna try to go in and be acrobatic. You wanna get the easy 2 points.
8-0 run as Alexander has busted open the 33-33 tie to take a 41-33 lead with 1:47 to play here in the third.
Turnovers, loose balls. You've got to attack the rim offensively if you're Alexander. Box, board, and run. Secure the rebound, advance the ball. One dribble gets you to the rim quicker, and that's Nelson with the easy 2 points in transition. See, Matt, a lot of times players, especially at the high school level, they want to showcase them on television, win a state championship game, look what I can do. And I can tell you, Coach Slate challenges players at halftime. Simplify the game, play inside out, and let's attack and transition.
Noah Melton, 10 points, 4-of-6 shooting, 4 rebounds, committed to play for the Chattanooga Mocs at the next level. He's got 4 of Alexander's 8 in this run, and Nelson has the other 4. Oh, Christian Brown on the dribble will bring it up top, reverse it to the other wing. Drive blocked by Lou. Run out again for the Cougars.
Now this is where you move the ball. When the defense is scattered, reverse the ball, no ISO, and then you attack the rim. Good job by Lee County, matching up well in transition, forcing a half-court play to Alexander.
Lou knocks down the three. Alexander has an 11-point lead.
But here's the other thing, though, Matt. When you get rhythm in basketball, when you get rhythm, now the three-point shots, it comes to you. But you got to establish some inside play, play to your strengths. Good job on Alexander and Lou knocking down the three-point shot.
Spin move, and Parker couldn't get it to go. Chroma keeps it alive. He couldn't get it to go. Scramble for the loose ball. He gets it again. Goes up. Chroma gets fouled. He goes to the line. And, Sean, you look at what Alexander has done differently here in this second half. They were 1-for-11 right, shooting the three ball in the first half. Coach Jason Slate said, let's cut down on the threes. Let's attack the hoop. They're only 1-for-2 shooting threes here in the third quarter.
And they built an 11-point lead with that mentality, attacking the rim, putting pressure on the defense of Lee County.
Chroma missed the first. Gets another. He's had a big quarter, 11 points and 8 rebounds for Osmani Chroma.
Now, Alexander, be prepared for full court pressure right here on the main shot. Lee County is going to try to extend the defense a little bit to try to force turnovers.
Got to hit those free throws. Lee County now 3-for-5 at the line in this game. That's going to be critical. Alexander has scored 7 more points at the free throw line than Lee County has. Inside to Lou, reverses it up and in. Lou now with 21 of Alexander's 46.
And that's not good basketball there, Matt. That's great basketball. High-low isolation, your top player, allow him to finish and get comfortable inside the paint.
Alexander has dominated this third quarter with 13 and a half seconds left in the period. They've outscored Lee 20-9.
But it's not about the dribble, it's the pass. The pass has been effective. The high-low action has been effective here in the second half for Alexander Cougars.
Dunson fading away, saves it. That's the end of the quarter. Lee County's got some ground to make up, and Alexander, after a huge quarter, put 20 on the board. After just 26 in the first half, now just 8 minutes away from their first ever state championship, and Braden Lou getting it done.
While we have a quick break from the action, did you know that the same area of just one basketball court can contain thousands of termites? That's why you need the expertise of Breda Pest Management to defend your home. Breda, the official pest control of high school basketball.
Let me know if I can help you with anything.
Just looking. I only buy local and sustainable, so.
Oh, well, that shirt's not local. You should be wearing cotton. Georgia's a major supplier of cotton worldwide, so if you'd like to buy local to support Georgia, buying cotton's a great place to start. It's renewable and sustainable, naturally.
Thanks.
Now that's a polyester fiber made of oil, by the way.
Where's your dressing room?
Sweetheart, please don't forget to wear your seatbelt.
I got it, Mom. It's a really nice day, living in the right space. Breathing your face, got me feeling some kind of way.
In the blink of an eye, so many tomorrows can disappear. Buckle up for your future. Every trip, every time. A message from the Governor's Office of Highway Safety.
Half of the nation's opioid overdoses happen right at home because people don't understand the dangers of taking an Oxy or Perc with a glass of alcohol for stress or to sleep. Learn how to protect your family from opioid overdose at opioidresponse.info.
46-33, Alexander 8 minutes away from perhaps their first ever state title. And this is about shot selection. 9-for-29 shooting in the first half. 8-of-15 in the third quarter for the Cougars.
Well, it's all about coaching. I mean, Coach Slate saw, guys, let me show you the stats. the stats don't lie. At halftime, the stats didn't lie. Credit to his team, Coach Slate, and his players. His players, they're trusting his coach, and they're playing now to their strengths versus their weakness.
Alexander closed the third quarter on a 13-0 run. Braden Lewis scored 11 of their 20 points in that period as they've blown it open. Caden Lee hits the mid-range jumper. Lee now has 8 points and 9 rebounds. Solid game from him. They're going to need more of that in the fourth quarter.
Yeah, and the interesting thing is Lee County, they missed their last 7 shots going into the fourth quarter, so it's positive for them to open up with 2 points.
Nelson with a huge three-pointer.
And that's what he does. He's a scorer. He has a scorer's mindset. He shoots the three effectively in rhythm. That was a good rhythm shot off the pass, off the bounce. Good three-pointer for the Alexander Cougars.
Skinner, three. Follow. Chroma, no one boxed him out. Team high 13 points. Rusmani Chroma. Can't wait to see him on the football field in the fall. Wing three, Nelson knocked it down, and now Alexander feeling it.
Well, they're moving the basketball. It's not one pass and shot, 3, 4, 5 passes. Once the rhythm gets in your footwork, once the rhythm gets in your mindset, shots start to fall down. That's great offense from Alexander.
Inside they go. Chroma got fouled on the play by Lou. That's going to be number one on Lou.
Well, Lou's got to play better defense than that. He basically turned his back on the offense, and Usman just being a presence down low, uses physicality to pick up the foul and get to the free throw line. Again, the full court pressure to be expected here by Lee County on the May free throw.
Lee County now 1 for 4 on free throws in the second half and 3 for 6 overall in the game. And again, a 7-point advantage for Alexander until that make right there at the free throw line. Lee County down 14 with just under 6.5 to go. Stolen away. Chroma gonna attack the basket. Lost the dribble. That's gonna be double dribble.
And see, I'm looking at the body language for Alexander. It's almost like they've gone into this fourth quarter with the W in mind versus let's keep playing our game. They have to stay focused, and that's going to be important. I'll look for Coach Slate to watch this closely because he may have to call a timeout to get his team a little bit refocused.
Yeah, championship has not been won yet. Backdoor cut and the slam by Marvin McGee.
Well, those kind of plays do help. Those kind of plays help, especially against the press. Inside out basketball, sideline dribble reverse, the former gets breaking the press, finishing with a nice dunk for McGee.
Taylor the other way, rebound controlled by Nelson. Coach Slate says they would not be here today if it was not for the jam right there by Lou and Alexander putting on a show. Back-to-back jams by McGee and then by Lou, and the lead is 18. Wow, watch your head. First, McGee and then Lou.
In lively towns and peaceful rural areas, Georgia's electric membership cooperatives are on a mission to provide a different kind of electricity. Our not-for-profit, member-owned EMCs are focused on making life better for members. At private residences, farms, and thriving businesses, we work for you. Generating safe, reliable, affordable electricity, giving back to local programs, serving our members to make life brighter. Georgia's EMCs, so much more than electricity.
At Regions Bank, we're here to listen to your needs, and we'll customize a plan to help you reach your financial goals. Our service to Georgia goes beyond banking to creating more inclusive prosperity in our communities. From education to financial wellness to economic development, we're working to level the playing field so more people can succeed and our communities can thrive.
Hey guys, it's time to reveal what I'm doing after graduation. We got my cupcakes and we got my schools. Let's just do it. Cupcakes aren't really my thing, and neither is going to a four-year college. Instead, I'm getting paid $18 an hour to train as a commercial plumber. There's a ton of other trades, like electrical and carpentry, where you can make great money, live a great lifestyle with little to no debt, and even be your own boss.
Since this game was tied at 33, Alexander has gone on a 23-5 run to blow it open. And now things are going to be very difficult for Lee County to try to come back and get in this game.
Well, the momentum was a little equal starting the fourth quarter with Lee County opening up with the jump shot. But Alexander, they started to attack the rim a little bit more. Then they started to make a three here and a three there and then get in the dunks in behind in sequence. Those things add to the momentum for you to win a game here and especially a championship tonight for the Alexander Cougars.
23 points for Braden Liu tonight. Having a huge game on the big stage, trying to get Alexander their first ever state title. Long three attempt by Christian Brown was an air ball. And now you're sensing some desperation in the Trojans.
Well, that was definitely a desperation shot, an ill-advised shot by Lee County, attacked the rim, and that's exactly what you should be doing.
Liu gets fouled on the play by Caden Lee.
And see, if you're going to press, you got to have someone in the back to either contain the drive or the overtop passes. And it looks like Lee County is starting to put those head down just a little bit. And Alexander's starting to have a little bit more fun out here on the court.
You see King playing hard. No dunks allowed, right? He's got that gauze stuffed up in his right nostril where he got whacked in the face earlier in the game.
Yeah, I've got 21 stitches in my left eye from Shaquille O'Neal and 22 in my other guy being just like him. Get out the way. It's only a basketball game.
Point lead for Alexander. Chroma gonna drive the baseline, shot blocked. Nelson got a piece of it. Dunson, here's the run out again for Alexander. Up and in, Melson.
And see, Melson, the entire team from Alexander, now they're attacking the rim in transition. There's nothing fancy about that, just avoiding the charge and getting the easy basket.
21-point lead. There's Taylor with the jumper. King got capped underneath. Another run out here for the Cougars. This time they throw it away.
But see, I love what Alexander is doing because they're using their height to contest the layups by Lee County. You can come into the paint, we'll contest it to block it, and then we'll leak out for the easy layup.
Look at the dramatic shift in the Alexander shooting percentages. Remember, they were at 31% at halftime, and they have shot 65%. A lot of them dunks here in the second half. Porter reverses it up and in. That's going to be an offensive foul. Threw the chicken wing out there at him.
But you can't lose focus if you're Alexander. You're starting to smell the roses and the game is not even over with. You know, but this is a young team for Alexander, and I'm sure you're going to enjoy the W. But if you're watching the tape down the road, Coach Slate's going to say, guys, for us to get better, we have to mature. Finish the game strong.
Turnaround. Shot it hard. Josiah Parker. He's 3-for-9 shooting in the game. Right in the middle, Liu spins, gets it up and in. He's got great body control.
At the rim, the way that he plays to his strength, attacking the goal, attacking the rim, getting easy baskets with layups.
26 for Liu, tip in. Parker tried to put it up and in. And here comes Liu. They're looking to break and dunk on every possession now. three, Nelson. Lou gets the offensive rebound. Now McGee, Eurostep. Tipping attempt. Controlled by Lee County. Christian Brown splits the defense. King gets his man up in the air and bounces off.
The rim is not kind for Lee County here in the fourth quarter. You started off with the two-point shot, and they just haven't been able to knock down anything to cut into this 21-point lead.
Frustration foul right there for Josiah Parker as the countdown is on. 2 minutes and 54 seconds before officially crowning Alexander champions.
All right, what do you think, Jasper?
Honestly, I think that polyester shirt's affecting your game.
What?
I think cotton would have been a better choice.
Cotton?
Yeah, it's come a long way, you know. Nowadays, cotton breathes and looks moisture great. Plus, buying cotton means supporting Georgia farmers. I think that's wonderful.
Okay, sure, but what do you think about the putt?
Oh, guess really hadn't thought about it.
Sweetheart, please don't forget to wear your seatbelt.
I got it, Mom. It's a really nice day, living in the right space. Breathing your face, got me feeling some kind of way.
Blink of an eye, so many tomorrows can disappear. Buckle up for your future. Every trip, every time. A message from the Governor's Office of Highway Safety.
Today's conservation-minded consumer cares about where their energy comes from. Your local EMC cares, too. Georgia's electric membership cooperatives offer renewable options for our members. In fact, our solar portfolio will produce enough clean energy to power more than 180,000 households. Striving to move the needle toward progress and position communities for the future. Georgia's EMCs, so much more than electricity.
2:54 to go on this one. Alexander, 61-40 lead on Lee County. Braden Liu scored 26. Here's a look at the Saturday schedule. It's a busy one. We tip at 11 a.m. with the Class 1A D1 Girls Final. St. Francis and Galloway will have the boys' slam dunk contest there in the middle. And we'll wrap up the night, the number one overall prospect in the nation, GPB Sports Player of the Year, Naismith National Player of the Year, Isaiah Collier leads Wheeler against the Cinderella Story Cherokee. That's at 7:30 tomorrow night. To cap 4 days and 17 championships.
Now, smart basketball for Alexander. Coach Slate being wise. Guys, now let's be patient. Move the ball around. We're not trying to be so aggressive. Even though we got a lead, we want to milk the clock and get out of here with a championship ring.
Wing three, Dunson.
And that was the nail. Dunson with the three. Braden Liu with the pass.
Alexander has outscored Lee County 38-12 here in the second half.
Well, they went to their strength. They went to their bread and butter, their advantage they have in the game, as that's their size and athletic ability. They gave up shooting the threes in the third quarter, and then they realized once the game opened up, rhythm got into play, and the three-point shots, they started to fall. But Alexander's a good team, a young team, a good team. And they got a chance to repeat because they got a majority of the team coming back next year.
Coach Slate bringing his seniors off the floor, his star players, letting them get a standing ovation and a bow in front of this Alexander crowd that made their way to Macon to see history being made in the Douglas County School. Lost out of bounds at this point. Just 2:05 to go. Lee County. Best season since 1985 is going to end at 28-4. Taylor misses the three. Liu bounces ahead. and intercepted by Skinner. Can't save it, though. And now Coach Slate bringing some of his other stars. Braden Liu, no doubt your player of the game, goes to the bench. A 26-point performance, 16 of those coming here in the second half as Alexander blew the game open. 26 points, 12 rebounds, 8 of 13 from the floor, 9 of 12 at the line.
And he's going to be good at the next level. He's got another year of maturity. He can tighten his game up. He can look at film. Where can he improve? Definitely his jump shot, but play to his strengths. If your strength is athletic ability, dive, cut to the rim. But then once he starts doing that, he can build on his jump shot and capabilities and improve and be a special player down the road.
And all the Alexander players stand up. They want to savor these final 1 minute and 47 seconds inside the miss. Alexander keeps it alive. Lee County comes away with it. They want to stand up and watch this one.
And I give credit to Lee County and Coach Davis of what they've accomplished. Like you said, Matt, best season since 1985, getting here to the state championship, to the finals. And he says this is a resilient program. When he inherited the program a few years ago, the players, they were hungry. They wanted to win. The community wanted to win. They backed him. His wife is the girls' head coach. So they've made it a family affair to make this a championship program. And if they keep working hard, summer workouts, mentality, and staying physical, I can see years down the road or even in the future where Lee County would be a state champion.
Yeah, it was interesting. He was at Colquitt County. The head coach there, his wife Tondra, was the girls' coach there at Lee County. And Lee County was coming off a two-win season. And she told her husband, he was commuting at the time. They're living in Leesburg. He's going to Moultrie. She said, look, I think he can help them out. It took a while. They had four straight losing seasons. They got to the state championship game this year. But it's going to be Alexander that wears the crown. Corner three. And the rebound controlled by Lee County as we wind down the final minute. And a foul is going to be called on Lee County on Nick Fabrizio, the son of the football coach, Dean Fabrizio.
And this is their time of celebration for the champs, for the Alexander Cougars representing the Douglas County area, where there's a lot of good basketball in that way on the boys and the girls' side. But Coach Slate, he knew that this was a season for his team. He prepared him in the fall. He prepared him in the summertime because he knew we have a chance to cut down nets in 2023.
Long three-pointer bounces over the backboard. And now we're down to 32.8. Shot clock is off. Alexander doesn't have to shoot anymore. They can run out the clock. And Jason Slate going down the line and handing out hugs.
Well, it's the journey. There's an emotion that people don't understand, that journey. It's not about the smiles you see right now. It's about the tears that were behind closed doors. It's about the highs and the lows of the season. And when you win a championship, all of that emotion comes out, and it's a fantastic feeling.
Here you go. Clock strikes zero. Alexander, state champions for the first time ever. Feeling for Coach Jason Slade and the Alexander Cougars, 28-5 here in 2022-23. Win number 28, the biggest of them all, as they run away from Lee County in the second half and beat the Trojans 64-42. 31-12 run to close out the game after it was tied at 33.
And Matt, we always say this, it's not how you start, it's how you finish, and then what adjustments you make. And Coach Slade and his staff and the team made adjustments at halftime. Guys, I know how we're started. We're not shooting the ball well. Let's look at the stats. Let's look at reality. Let's get back to what's going to get us a W. We got to dive. We got to slash. We got to cut. We've got to get into the rim. We got to score inside the paint and use our height and our strength to our advantage.
Well, you know, they learned from their semifinal victory over Etowah. The same thing happened in the first half in that game. And Coach Slade said, look, we were one pass and jacking threes, and that wasn't going to get it done. They made the adjustment there. They made the adjustment again tonight, and it changed the game.
Well, his team listened to him. And so that's a credit to Coach Slate. His team listened to him.
All right, let's send it to John Nelson.
Time to hand out the last trophy for day number three, and we're going to do it in 6A boys. First up, the runner-up trophy. And here to present it to Lee County, the executive director of the Georgia High School Association, Dr. Robin Hines.
First, I'd like to say thank you to all the fans that came out here today to support your team. Bunch of folks from Lee County came, Alexander as well, and two of the best student sections I think we've ever seen. Got a lot to be proud of. We want to congratulate Lee County on a great, great season, and I want to give the boys basketball state runner-up 6A trophy to Lee County Trojans. Congratulations, Coach.
Which means we have one more trophy to hand out here on a Friday night, and it's going back to Douglas County. Alexander, you've got your first. Come on out here to center circle. Coach Slate and everybody else, come and get that trophy and that basketball and get it ready to get it all the way back out I-20 to Alexander. And here once again, Dr. Robin Hine.
Congratulations, Coach.
God is good.
Well, on behalf of Breda Pest Management and the Georgia High School Association, it gives me great pleasure to award you the 6A Boys Basketball State Championship Trophy. Now, Coach, I want to give you a chance to tell us what this means for you, your program, and your community.
For me, you know, it's unbelievable. We prepared for this all year. We started preparing when we got beat last year. For the kids, they bought in, you know, 100%. They played great, played the toughest schedule in 6A. I believe that helped us tonight. For Alexander, this is the greatest. This is the greatest. Our fans have been awesome all year. Here we go.
That's your trophy in 6A. We'll be back here to make it in just a little bit to catch up with Slate, Coach Slate, and Braden Liu. But for now, let's send it back to Atlanta.
Love the emotion of the victory, Sean. There's nothing like it.
Oh, man, we talk about winning the state championship. Win a championship at any level, you're going to embrace the emotion. Congratulations to Alexander and the Cougars for cutting down the nets and having a grand, fantastic season.
Stick around. When we come back, we'll hear from Coach Jason Slade and our player of the game, Braden Liu. More to come from Macon in just a moment.
Best defense to stopping bugs and critters? That would be Breda Pest Management, protecting homes all over Georgia for nearly 50 years. See why so many homes are protected by Breda Pest Management at bredapest.com.
At Regions Bank, we're here to listen to your needs, and we'll customize a plan to help you reach your financial goals. Our service to Georgia goes beyond banking to creating more inclusive prosperity in our communities. From education to financial wellness to economic development, we're working to level the playing field so more people can succeed and our communities can thrive.
We continue our coverage of National Signing Day. We go now to Atlanta, Georgia for Kevin Connor's official declaration.
After giving it much thought, I've decided that next year I'll be going pro and building my skills as a Georgia plumber!
What impacted your decision?
It was an opportunity to earn money and learn on the job. I really love working with my hands, building things, and being part of a team.
another highly touted prospect enters the trades.
Go Plumbers!
'64-'42, the final. Alexander knocks off Lee County, wins their first ever state championship. We've got a full day on our final day in Macon. Five more state champions will be crowned in Class 1A D1. The girls, St. Francis and Galloway, Kings Ridge Christian and Mount Pisgah. In the boys, the Adaptive Sports Championship at 3, boys slam dunk at 5. And then we go to 7A, the biggest classification. The girls at 5:30, that'll be Brookwood versus Norcross. And in 7A boys, Wheeler versus Cherokee at 7:30. Now back to John Nelson in the Coliseum.
Thank you very much, Matt. Time to catch up with our player of the game, Braden Liu. All right, you've got the medal, you've got the basketball. That obviously has got to go in glass back home. What's it like to come out on top?
It feels good. We deserve this. We had a tough schedule all year. I'm glad I can send my seniors off with a ring this year.
Seven seniors, what's it like to send them out with a title first ever in school history?
It feels good. They worked hard for this since I started playing with them, so I'm proud of them.
What was the conversation like? It was tight early, then tied at 33. What were the conversations like to put the pedal down to where you guys really put distance between where they only scored 9 points and when you were tied?
They told us we couldn't take them lightly, and that's what we did. So we had to relock in and do what we do best.
26 points for you to finish, and they're showing your action up here on the big board. See, you're not allowed to get caught looking at yourself. Come on now. 26-12 by the time you were done. What was it like out there tonight going up against a really tough team in Lee County?
I know what I had to do to coming in, so I just stuck to that and made sure we got the win.
All right, so take that basketball and go celebrate with the fellow students, but don't lose that. That's important. I'm going to come over here and catch up with Coach Slate and all of our interviews with coaches brought to us by our friends at Breda Pest Management, the official sponsor of high school basketball. Has it sunk in yet?
No, it hasn't. It hasn't. I got a feeling it's about to. It's been an incredible run. It's been an incredible year. Like you said, seven seniors, you know, that bought into the plan. And so I'm really excited for them, really excited.
What was the plan for those that don't pay attention to Alexander basketball? How would you describe what the plan is that they bought into?
You know, the plan was, you know, we've got a lot of guys that were good offensively. And getting them to share the ball with each other, you know, and not really caring who got the credit. You know, that I thought that was the biggest thing. Early in the game, that's we had to remind because we were taking some really quick shots. But I think you saw, you know, especially the second half, them helping each other score. And that was, I thought that was the key.
First ever in school history. I know that everybody here got to see the excitement. How's that stomach working right now?
Oh, man. I'm just ready to, you know, celebrate with some of these friends and family that came down here, you know, and just had wonderful support.
Go celebrate.
Yes, sir. Thank you. Appreciate it.
Jason,
go Cougs.
Jason Slate, the head coach of Alexander. Matt, that is the end of day 3 at the Macon Coliseum and the Macon Centerplex. Our 6A champs, Alexander, first time ever. Back to you.